My mic is muted, sir. Nobody is telling. Are you? What are you doing, you people? Nobody mentioning. Very bad.
Sir, we thought you were waiting for people.
But you should tell me, no. My
Sorry,
mic
sir.
Is not unmuted. Actually, I'm talking from 10 minutes like a mad fellow.
Sir, it's just PPT. Now we were not able to see. That's why.
No, I last class.
If it was on the board, we would have known that you were speaking.
Okay. No problem.
Sorry, sir.
No problem. It's my mistake also there. Okay. What can we do? Come on, again, we start the story from beginning. See, yesterday, five-party graph is already we said actually what is the meaning is what. Suppose V1, V2 is one set and U1, U2, U3, U4 is another set. Five-party means what? From one set, one vertices if you take means what? It's connected to the two, that is what? One. This is one set means what? One set by U1 is another set. So this should be connected to the another set of vertices. V1 is connected to V1, V2. Then U2 is what? V1 is not connected, but it should be connected actually. Like V2. Or any one set is enough. It's not need to all sets. But condition is what? You don't get the in same set of one edge. U1, U2, you don't get the edge actually. Suppose if you take one vertex means what? It should connected to the one form edge means what? In another set vertex. Means what? You can say biparty graph. See, U2 is connected V1 only. Okay. Then U3 connected is what? V1, V2. U4 connected only V2. Okay, this is biparty. Complete biparty means what you will get actually. If you take one vertex, you see, from this, all edges is connected to all vertex of the other sets. See, from A to this A, A to this B, A to C, A to D. But here you don't get form. So this is called complete biparty. Biparty, okay? So if you two sets partial partitions, two sets means what? Biparty means what? Complete means what? From one set if you take any vertex of the one set of in one set if you take any vertex, that vertex connected to the all vertex of another set is called complete. If it is at least connected means what? It should be connected another vertex. Means what is called biparty. Because U1 connected to V1, V2. But U2 is not connected, but connected to another vertex, enough. U3 also, U4. This is just biparty. Complete means what? Every vertex is connected. So, means complete. Okay? Now, this is very, very important. The number of edges in biparty graph with n vertices at most n squared by 4. Now, we write let the vertex of the set partition two sets, V1, V2. Let V1 contain x vertices, V2 contain n minus x, totally n vertices means what? The large number of edge of graph can be obtained when each of x vertices in V1 connected to the n minus 1 x, correct? Vertices in V2. Therefore, the largest number of edges what? F of x could be x into n minus x is a function of x. In +2 level already, you are done actually maximum minima. How you will find maximum minima, tell me? F of x given means what you will do first? F of x is in your hand, then how you will do actually maximum minima? Find f dash x equal to 0, you will get extreme points. Then find f double dash x. Then if f double dash x is less than 0 at that point means what you can say function attains maximum. Greater than 0 means what? Function attains minimum. Less means maximum, greater. So similarly what you will do? F of x is x into n minus x. F dash x you can find out. Then f dash x equal to 0. F dash is what? Minus 2 f dash equal to 0. Then x is equal to n by 2. F double dash of n by 2 is what? Less than 0. If you substitute it here, guarantee it's less than 2. So means what? F of x is maximum when x is equal to n by 2. Then what is the maximum value you can fix in here? N by 2 you can substitute it in here. N square by 4 in here. So like an ordinary +2 problem actually. Come on, note down. have isomorphism. The simple graph g1, v1, e1 and g2, v2 are isomorphic. There exist 1 to 1 and onto function from f, from v1 to v2. With the property a and b are adjacent in g1, if and only if f of a and f of b are also adjacent in g2. For all a comma b belongs, is called an isomorphism. Two simple graphs are that not isomorphic call is non-isomorphic. So that means what is corresponding? You see u1 degree is what? 2. u1 corresponding v1 is 2. So 2 edges means what? 2. So this graph is isomorphic. g2 x if you take. F of u1 is equal to v1. Corresponding you can see it. u1, v1, 1, 1. u2, v2. So how many edges are there? Degree of u2 is what? Degree of u2 is 2. Degree of v2 also u. Here how many edges are there? 4. Here also how many edges are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's an isomorphic. Now this is in G. This is G, this is H. Corresponding is what? U1 corresponding is V1. Correct? U1 is what? 3, V1, 3. U2 is what? 2 edges. But V2 is what? 3 edges. So, phase. So, in G, vertices is 5, edges in 6. In H is what? Vertices in 5, is the number of edges both in the graph, G are not equal, therefore is not an isomorphic. You can say. Show that the graphs are not isomorphic. How will you feel? Suppose V1 corresponding U1 means what? V1 degree is what? Degree of V1 2. U1 also 2. V2 corresponding U2. But V3 corresponding U3. Here pairs. U3, how many degree U3 is what? 1, 2, 3. But V3 is what? So it's not adjacent. But after that, this is adjacent. So V3, V4 means not adjacent. It's not an isomorphic. Here also this corresponding V1 corresponding U1 over there, V2 corresponding U2 over there, but V3 U3 phase, then V4 U4 phase, V5 U5. So it's not an isomorphic. Now we see. A walk in G is a finite non-null sequence. Walk, how can you write? Start with some vertices. A, G. That is what? V1, E1, V1, E2, next V, EK. Whose terms are alternately vertices and edge. Such that for 1 is equal to I is equal to K, the end EI, VI minus 1, VI. W is a walk from V to VK. From starting to last, you can walk. The vertices are V0 and VK are called the origin and terminus, initial and terminus. The W respectively V1, V2, V2 is what? Internal vertices, the integer K length of W. It is E1, E2, E1 part is what? Distinct, the W is called trail. The vertices V0, V0 distinct, W is called path. Now we can see here. Walk is starting, you see, U, A, V, you see, U, A, V, F, Y, F, V, F, Y, G, Y, H, W. So, one vertex, U, A, V, then F, coming F, Y, then V, FY, again coming back actually, FY, FV, GY is walking like this, then HW, then BV, okay, so this is a walk, started with U, ended with V, edge. Then trial. What is telling trial actually? Walk means you have vertices that origin and end is axis that W, respectively V1, V2 is the internal vertices. The integer K is the length of W. The edges E1, E2, E3 are of the walk. Then W are distinct, W is called trial. Now is what, from where it's starting in W C X C X D Y H W B V G Y. If internal edges are different, this is called trial. Correct? There is no repetition because your repetation is there. Terminal means what is not a trial. Trial means what? It won't get actually same actually. So once if you use actually. Path means what is telling? If the vertices V0, V1 they are distant, then W is called path. It won't repeat it actually. Is called path. V1, V2, V3 all is different in this one. You can say it's a path, all vertices. Then the integer K is the length of W. Then if the edges E1, E2 are equal to path, W are distant, then W is called trial. Then edges are not repeating here. U, where we have started actually, W, C, X, B, Y, H, H, W, B, V, G, Y. So, path. Again, I will explain this. I just note down. Again, cycle. A walk is closed if it has a positive length and it is origin and terminus are the same. A closed trial whose original internal vertices are distinct is cycle. A walk is closed if it has a positive length and it is its origin and terminus are same. Where it starts, same way. U and V are same. This is closed trial. A closed trial whose arm and internal vertices are distant is on cycle. So where it starts same only you can end, but different actually. It's called cycle. A closed trial whose origin and terms are distant cycle. Here where you are going X A U B, V, H, X, cycle completed. Then closed trial means what? U, C, V, H, X, G, W, F, W, B, V, B, U. Just note down, sir. I'll again explain. now next theorem. If a graph G either connected or not has exactly two vertices of odd degree, then there is a path joining these two vertices. Let G is connected, let V1, V2 be only vertices of G which are of odd degrees. But we have already proved odd vertices even. Just last theorem, clearly there is a path connecting V1, V2 since G is connected. Case 2, G is disconnected. Then component of G is connected, hence V1, V2 should belong to the same component of G. Hence, the path between V1, V2. Path is between V1, V2. So, two cases, if connected also, not connected also, it should be two join vertices. This is also important, sir. The maximum number of vertices in a simple connected graph G when vertices k components is n minus k into n minus k plus 1. It's very, very important. Let the number of vertices ith component G is what? I is greater than 1. Then what you get? 1, 1, n2, nk is equal to n. Then is equal to sigma notation if we add all n mv2. Then n minus 1 means what? N minus 1 times I'm adding. So this is what n1 minus k. I is equal to no, k. 1 you will get k times n1, n2, n3, that is ni. K, how many ones you will get? 1, 2, 3, k times 1 you will get minus k. So n minus k. Then squaring both sides. Is there any way? x1 square, x2 square, 10% guarantee this. You can expand this. Sigma is equal to unity. Now, maximum number of edges, ith component G is 1 by 2 n minus n minus 1. So, maximum number of edges, this is. Stop here. And you at least next class remaining will be again the 7 guys, don't worry. 569.
Yes, sir.
70. Seventy-one. 72.
Present, sir.
73.
Present, sir.
74.
Present, sir. Huh? Present, sir. 74.
75.
Present, sir.
76.
Present, sir.
77.
Present, sir.
78.
Present, sir.
79.
Sir, 80 present.
81.
Present, sir.
82.
Present, sir.
83.
Present, sir.
84.
85.
85.
86.
Present,
sir. 87.
88. 89. 88. Present, sir. 89 also present, sir.
Okay. 90.
Present, sir.
91.
Present, sir.
92.
Present, sir.
93. 94. 95. 96.
Sir, 97. Present.
98.
Present, sir.
99.
Present, sir.
100.
Present, sir.
Not 102. 103.
603 present.
Sorry, 601. 602. 603.
603 present, sir.
604.
Present, sir.
605.
Present, sir.
606.
The present, sir.
607.
Present, sir.
608. 609. 610.
Present, sir.
611.
Present, sir.
6:12.
Present, sir.
6:13.
Present, sir.
6:14.
Present, sir.
6:15.
Present, sir.
6:16. 6:17. 6:18.
Present, sir.
6:19.
Sir, chat box.
Chat box, sir.
Okay. 6:20.
Present, sir.
31.
Present, sir.
32. Present. 23.
Present, sir.
34.
Present, sir.
35.
Present, sir.
36.
Yes, sir.
37.
Present, sir.
38.
Present, sir.
39. 30.
Present, sir.
31.
Present, sir.
32.
Present, sir.
I think 6:32 last number. Yes.
Sir, 5:70 present, sir.
5:70,
sir.
What are you doing?
5:85 present, sir.
Okay. Right, sir. Next class, again, I will explain, don't worry, this graph fully, cycle path, it's up to now, just you can send the note, just you can see.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, okay. Can you send the notes of all four, five?
Yeah, units? Yeah, 5 units I'll send you.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.